Jane, it's me. Open up. Did you tell anyone?
Did I?
About the name, the name.
Well, yeah, I told Rick. He thought it was funny.
Just Rick and nobody else?
No. Why, what's the matter? Larry, what's wrong?
I'm sorry. You have no idea how sorry I am.
Larry, you're scaring me. What are you doing?
Rick, the name. Did you tell anyone? Anyone?
Please, please.
Rick, he's coming. The name.
Giselle. I told Giselle.
Don't think. Don't say. Don't think. Don't say. Don't think. Don't say. Don't think. Don't say. Don't think. Don't say.
Giselle! Did you say the name?
It's a good day.
You got the key?
No, it's under the mat. It's only 20 minutes. This is the first time he's rented the place. The guy says it's fantastic.
What else would he say? It's a doghouse?
I'm trying to convince her. Let's go. Come on, man. Work with me.
Gosh. Yeah, I'm up for it.
Desk over there. We could put the bed here.
Well, maybe if there was a bed.
Well, the landlord said it was fully furnished.
Yo, Al, come and check this out, man. This is crazy. Yo, come on down.
Yo, Al, come in here, man.
Oh,
you can't get this in the dorms, right? Now that's. That's classic.
John, you really think Sasha wants to see that? Or that?
Oh. You got the whole upstairs to make early, okay?
I've definitely seen bigger.
See? You were awesome. Bro. She's awesome, man.
Oh, yeah, you guys must have been hilarious when you were young.
Must have been. Far. Tier one.
Hey, he made me look smart, and I made him look ugly.
But after the crash, he took care of me.
Talk shit about my boys, folks. You're done.
Okay, and the tier ones are both ready to cook and clean and help me do this place up right. Because I'm not going to be your guy's maid.
Of course not. I told him. Right?
Why, I never cooked you my butter pasta next.
That is not a thing.
That's because I invented it.
Okay.
And I clean too. I promise. Yo, what does this do?
Yeah, you cook.
That's how I cook, okay? I don't bake.
Found the furniture.
I've heard about you and all the girls.
And that's exactly why we need to get out of the dorms. This is perfect.
Oh, easy. You all right?
Yeah. Thanks.
So it looks like the landlord wasn't lying.
Wow.
Damn, son.
like this.
So?
Don't you want to?
Well, yeah, I do. Now I know you.
Yo, all the dishes in here, they're white. Just saying.
He touches everything. It's up to you, Bear.
I can't afford it without him. I know you can't, but
Elliot,
I don't want you to.
Elliot.
Yeah.
We're doing it, obviously.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I see she approves, huh?
Hey, you need a hand?
No, I got this.
Hey, don't break yourself.
Better than going to the gym, right?
Banging?
Yeah. The radiators sound worse.
Okay, Bear, here it is. Rilke says, coins symbolize the wonder and terror of fortune. Do you land face up or face down in the dirt? What home will you be born into? With whom will you fall in love? Fortune is truly like a coin tossed by the hand of God.
Something stupid?
Mm-hmm. Just us, yeah.
I'm gonna brush my teeth. Hey, what's on the bed?
You look like a model from the 70s. The personal pilot of a James Bond villain. A 19-year-old koala bear person. If any of them were true, I wouldn't have you. But they're not. And I do. Amazingly. Bullshit aside, I never thought I would meet, let alone be with, anyone like you. With so much love. Your knight, Beau, Casanova, and new roommate, Elliot. No animals were harmed in the making of this card. Hey, Elliot, that's not funny. Elliot?
What's up, man?
Oh, little brother.
Look at this place. Fantastic. Hi, darling.
Hi, Uncle Elliot.
Hey, niece Alice.
Hey.
Hey there. Sorry, we're so early. Your brother's pathological.
It's called being prompt and professional.
Virgil's awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, hey. I almost forgot.
Here's your housewarming present.
You can help me drink it?
No.
Look at this. So a house off campus with John Henry and a live-in girlfriend. You ready for this?
She's the one, Virgil. She did all this herself.
It's great. It's just, you know, be smart. Be a student, man. It's the last time to have no responsibilities. Enjoy it.
I don't want that. I want what you have. An amazing wife, an amazing daughter.
Just don't rush it. It's all out there waiting for you. Believe me, what I have is great. It is. But I missed out on all this. I mean, what a college education could have done for me. You have a scholarship, man. You should be upstairs studying right now. Jesus, it's a good thing you're not jealous.
It is good.
The old gold coin, huh?
Yeah, I put it back on the little table next to the bed. I didn't want to keep it.
It's because you're the best, most honest, smartest, cutest, heaviest, oldest person here.
I'm not the heaviest. Or the oldest. That's the oldest, and he's the heaviest.
Fuck!
Ratting me out.
Here. Head bump. Fist bump.
That's John's room. We're upstairs.
All right, we're out of here. Buddy.
Hey, good. Bye, guys. Bye, Alice.
Kim, she's in my lit class.
Girls who wear hats inside are crazy. You know that, right?
She's gonna do a psychic cleansing after everyone leaves.
Cool, can I leave too?
No. She's just gonna burn some sage and you are gonna be nice.
Maybe you need a hat.
The twist off.
Oh, thank you. John, do you think this house is creepy?
Yeah.
I don't, but I'm not a girl. And I think you should get dressed, because play baseball.
Why do jocks always have to play games, even at a party? Don't think it, don't say it. 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 Don't say it, don't think it.
Miss Sasha steps up to the plate.
Oh, she's going long, she's going long.
Okay, all right, all right. You got this? All right. Oh! Yes!
You're right.
Drunk.
So you thought there were sounds and what? Bad vibrations?
Yeah. And now if they're gone, then what's the big deal?
We burned all that bad shit away, right? That's tight. You're actually psychic.
Sensitive, my mother says.
Oh, sensitive, huh? So what? Your mom locked you under the stairs when you was a kid? You shoot knives at her?
Yeah. But I could find stuff. I always knew when people were coming over to the house.
You know what I'm thinking?
Yes. I might just do that.
Yeah. You are psychic.
Sensitive there for sure.
Elliot.
It's okay, Sasha. People have doubted me my whole life. Elliot, you can go ahead and live a sheltered, shallow physical existence.
Well, a non-physical existence would be kind of tough.
What Aristotle is trying to say is, well, he needs proof.
Yeah, is that crazy?
Okay, let's just take some deep breaths.
Okay.
So if nothing happens, I should believe because it means you got rid of the spirit?
Elliot, come on.
What?
We all know you don't believe in the stuff, okay? But can you just please let her do it?
Right. Sorry. No being rational. I give over. I do.
Oh, Al, just loosen up the grip a little bit. I'm trying to concentrate on my breathing.
Are you ready? Ladies?
Okay, let's do this thing. Come on.
Now, I have no ego about it, but I do know this stuff.
Okay, cool. Well, what do you know?
I know your parents died in a crash.
Dude.
He didn't tell me. They did.
Bro. I didn't say anything. I swear.
Never tell anyone that.
They're worried about you, though.
All right. I'm sorry I laughed at you before, but that's not funny.
I'm not being funny, Elliot. This is just what I'm getting.
Okay. How did they die? What kind of accident was it?
Your brother will do anything in his power to protect you now. But they worry that he's taking on too much.
All right. So you talked to my brother tonight.
Sasha, your grandmother has some biscuits or rolls or something.
Gams rolls?
Come on. Everybody's grandma bakes biscuits.
Yeah, he's not wrong about that.
This is... You know what?
You want to blindfold me, too?
Just hang on. I'll take you up on that, though. I'm all down for the blindfolding, whatever you got.
Of course.
Okay. What I hide, where'd I hide it?
Oh, come on. Come on,
Elliot.
It's crazy.
Shh.
You know what? I don't like this. Yeah, I don't want to do this anymore. Maybe this was a bad idea.
No, come on. You're a good faker, I admit it.
You put the keys in a pot on the stove.
Did you?
You heard.
were listening for it, weren't you?
Well, I didn't hear that, did you?
No.
Something's coming.
What?
They're saying, don't think it. Don't say it. Don't say it, don't think 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 it.
Don't say or think what? The bye-bye man.
Oh, jeez.
What the fuck?
Oh, Jim. Oh, my God.
Hey. What happened?
John.
What? Hey, you're joking, right? Sasha, you're kidding, right?
Hey.
Shh.
What are you doing?
Did you hear that? What the hell is that?
Thanks for being nice to me last night. That was pretty crazy.
It was. Definitely.
You want to go inside? My roommate's car is in here. We could try again. These things happen, right?
Oh, actually, not to me, they don't.
Actually, not to me either. Kind of finishing up. I've never had that happen before. Come on. I'm hungry.
Jesus.
What?
Nothing. Nothing, okay? Kim, I need to go. Now. Fuck.
Check this out.
They were already there, right?
No.
Like, it was Colin or one of those douches from last night.
No, listen, I heard it. I heard something after the party outside, scratching.
What do you mean you heard something? Clean and beautiful. It's nice.
What was that?
John, you drive Kim home?
Yeah. And now I gotta wash her off.
The girl's gross, man.
Total pig.
Oh man, that's not cool. Don't say that.
Oh sure, yeah, it's easy for you to say. Your girlfriend's perfect.
Oh God.
You okay?
I don't know, maybe I shouldn't be playing baseball in the cold.
That's the problem with being an alcoholic.
Oh shut up, I didn't even drink that much.
Maybe that was the mistake. I'll make you some tea. For a second.
I did.
Where'd she go? God, you're shivering.
I was just thinking.
About John?
Little brother, it's cool. You call
me anytime, you know that.
Are you really taking on too much? Are you worried about protecting me?
What is going on?
Is it Sasha?
Yeah, she's been really sick and scared. And John's been acting weird.
You guys seem like you were great.
Where were we? You saw them dancing together.
Talk to me, buddy. What's going on?
Elliot.
What?
You wanted to get lunch tomorrow or something? We'll talk about this then.
You know what? Listen, I gotta go. There's something I gotta... I gotta deal with something.
Yep.
Guys! Guys, what are you doing up there?
Hello? Anyone down there? Hello?
We were, Elliot.
But you didn't answer me.
We didn't hear you.
What were you doing?
Studying, talking.
You didn't
hear me. We weren't doing anything.
You didn't hear me.
Elliot, for the last time, bro. We wouldn't do that to you.
Why are you lying to me?
We're not.
Jesus Christ. Then what just happened, huh? And there were sounds. I mean, come on.
I told you there was something happening. Now, do you believe me?
Hey, don't worry, okay?
What are you doing?
Don't do that.
Don't do what?
Don't.
Elliot.
Don't touch her.
What?
Don't touch her.
You are crazy paranoid, bro.
Yeah, you're a little warm. Okay, so you weren't with John. But am I hearing things? Am I seeing things?
Tonight, you thought the house was empty when we were here. You went away, Elliot. I kind of went away, too. down to study. I don't remember doing any of that. It's like now that I know his name, he's coming for me. And the more I try to get rid of it, the bigger it gets. It's horrible.
My man's not real. It's just something that's in our heads.
That's real. Ideas are real. If it's not, then Elliot, we're all losing our minds at the same time. And what are the chances of that? Gonna be late, right?
No, I'll meet you at 2 o'clock sharp, right where we parked. I'm gonna find out how real this thing is. The name. You're gonna talk to the landlord about the furniture?
And the house. Maybe he can find somewhere else.
You're feeling better, though?
I guess. It's hard to be scared in the middle of the day.
I'm gonna take care of you. I'm gonna figure this out, I promise. I'll see you at 2 o'clock. I love you.
I love you.
These on.
Really?
Yeah. They're originals, and we don't want your sweaty palms messing up the documents in the box. Now, the dead file has dead articles, material that got killed before going to press, but still saved for posterity. And it was written by Redmond.
Thanks.
Daisy?
Yes, how are you doing?
Not so great, actually. Me and my friends are renting your place out in Sun Prairie. 37 Oakdale.
Oh, yeah, the two handsome guys. Are you with them?
You have a weird house, Mr. Daisy. Really, it's awful.
Well, I'm sorry that you feel that way, but they did sign a lease. Bless you.
Oh, sorry.
You okay?
It's really cold in here.
It's a hot house. It's actually not cold at all, honey. Maybe you should be home in bed.
Look, Mr. Daisy, there was an old nightstand in the basement, and it has this writing inside it. Where did it come from?
A nightstand.
Let's begin by considering this wall. Now, we can all agree that the sentence...
Sorry.
Yeah, have a seat. Now, we can all agree that this sentence, this is a wall, is a truth claim. This wall is real. I see it, you see it. We can touch it. Likewise, if I were to brush a few atoms from this wall, it would still be here. It would still be here before us. It would still be the wall. But what if I continue to slowly brush the atoms one by one away from this wall? Well, at first you'd say, well, it's still a wall. I brush a few more, well, it's still a wall. But what if I remove every single atom from this wall except for one? And you've seen me brush every single atom from this wall except for that one atom. And I point to it, and I say, look, that's what's happening. Now, is this?
What the f-
All right, John?
Welcome back. Language and reality inform each other as we construct.
Okay, I'm looking up the Bye Bye Man, right? There's nothing online, so I type in Don't Say It, Don't Think It, and it led me here, the Dead Archives and Redman. Here's what was in his folder. I think you write it and repeat it to try and keep from saying...
The Bye Bye Man. Okay, but why is that in the Dead files?
October 18th, 1969, byline Larry Redman, Deerfield, Iowa, a teenager accused of murdering his own family and four other youths. When asked by this reporter why he would do such a thing, he replied, "The bye-bye man made me do it." It's an article about a kid who went crazy, but it was never published.
And Larry Redman, the writer, he was pretty infamous locally. After he killed this piece about the kid in Deerfield, Larry Redman took a shotgun and murdered eight friends and family members right here in Madison.
Don't say it. Don't say it. Don't think it. Don't say it.
Mom, shut the door!
Don't you tell!
No! We didn't kill anyone, Larry!
Maybe he got inspired by what he was writing about.
Thank you.
There are no other mentions of these cases anywhere else. It's like someone redacted the whole story so no one else could read it.
Why would anyone do that?
Well, obviously he was batshit crazy. But if you remove all references to something in the past, that past no longer exists. Even the idea of it's gone. Maybe somebody wanted to make this bye-bye man disappear permanently. And you've got the last record of it right there. I'll be back.
Good, I have time. Don't write it either, idiot.
Boy, are you out of your mind?
I.
What is wrong with you, Elliot?
What the?
Huh?
I'm sorry. I need to go. I'm late.
Elliot.
Hello?
Kim, it's Elliot.
God, I was just thinking about you guys.
You want to come up?
Listen, what are you doing?
You mean right now or since the party?
Isn't that why you're here?
Kim, can you come down? I want to do another seance.
Right now, with all four of us. At the house. Listen, you were right.
I was wrong.
Sure. I'll be down in a sec.
The Bye-Bye Man doesn't exist anywhere else that I could find.
You don't have to look for him, Elliot. He's found us. You can't help thinking about him. And the more you think about him, the closer he gets. You see things that aren't there. You don't see things that are there.
Or hear things. Like a coin rolling.
Yeah. Like a dream. Some people catch it, and it spreads. Some go crazy sooner, but they all die in the end. The word spreads and he comes to you with
thing.
I told Katie. I didn't want to. What can you do with cancer but cut it out? You have to stop it before it spreads and every cell dies. This could spread everywhere if we don't cut it out. Did you tell anyone?
Miss Watkins, the librarian.
We have to get to her, too.
What do you mean you have to get to her?
Stop! Oh, my God. Stop! Elliot, stop!
Killed her. You were right. He's trying to get inside us. He got in her. He's gonna drive us crazy and he's gonna kill us.
You mean the...
Yeah. He's why I was late to get you. He's why you're feeling sick. Have you said the name to anyone?
The name? No.
Have you?
No, I haven't said...
Don't. We can't say the name to anyone else ever.
You gonna tell me what to do now?
Like... Swear you won't say the name so we don't spread it.
No.
John, please.
Bro, swear it.
You just need to cut the shit.
You swear. Swear.
No.
Swear.
Elliot, stop it.
I swear.
What's wrong with you, Elliot? What's wrong with you, huh?
Hey, guys. Hey, break it up. I said break it up right now. Back up.
He got to you, didn't he?
No one got to me, all right?
Admit it. He's making you feel angry. He's making you sick.
Yeah? He's making you crazy.
You on something?
No, I'm upset.
We were just having a little argument.
You call that a little argument?
Please don't say it.
Don't say what?
Sasha.
What?
Say you can't.
This name or some stupid shit Elliot thinks is dangerous.
Yes, I was talking about Kim. There was a hammer in her bag. It was covered with blood.
Oh, my God.
Train's engineer said that you were chasing Kim with a hammer. He said she was crying for help and that she jumped out of your car to get away from you.
Jesus Christ, Elliot.
That's not what happened.
No, they found Kim's roommate, Katie Williams. She was killed by a hammer too, but you knew that, didn't you?
Sasha, no, that, I was at the library. He made me lose track of time.
Sasha. Do you want to talk to me here? You want to tell me what's going on?
Don't say it. Don't think it. You were right.
Quiet. Sasha, what doesn't he want you to say?
Yes, Sasha.
You! Shut it!
It just happened, John.
You see that? It's him.
No.
Sasha.
What is it?
Blood.
Blood? Where?
What do you see? He makes you see things. Fuck.
Hey. Back away. I need you over here. She's fine. Stay back.
Wait, there he is.
Hey, bud, something wrong?
What?
I'm sorry. Hey, you all right?
Wait, Sasha.
He's gonna take her home. I'm just gonna lie down for a bit.
I'm her boyfriend. She needs me.
Maybe later, but right now you're gonna come with me. We're gonna talk a little bit.
Did you say the name to anyone?
She didn't, man. Neither of us did.
Good news for you? Maybe. Kim Hines wrote a suicide note taking responsibility for her roommate and for the deaths of you and the other two living at your house. So I guess she was planning on killing you too. Is that what happened, Elliot? You found out and you chased her? I don't think that's murder. You want to write it?
No.
You're going to tell me, you know that?
I hope not.
Why did you chase Kim?
I told you I was trying to help her.
So you chased her into a train. What are you doing? You could lose everything. Your scholarship, that pretty girl. You are a smart kid. Talk to me and I can help you. Otherwise, it'll be out of my hands, and you will be wishing that you had.
You might find yourself wishing I had.
Will you let me worry about that?
You really want to know? You really think the truth, honesty, is the best policy?
I do.
Always.
When wouldn't it be?
You have kids?
Maybe.
You have kids. What if you saw the worst crime scene ever? A mass murder at a school. With dead bodies and brains and students and sneakers with blood on them. And you go home. And your kids say, "Tell us about your day, Mommy." You could be honest. You could tell the truth. You could describe every awful nightmare thing you saw, and what was burned into your head would be burned into their heads forever. Or you could hug them tight and spare them your honest truth. What would you do? Me say it. I haven't hurt anyone, but I'm afraid of putting this into your head. You and your kids. You're all dead.
Hey, Elliot. Your friend died? What the hell is going on, man?
Thanks for coming to get me, but I gotta go.
Well, is it Sasha and John? Hey, talk to me. Let me help you.
Okay, whatever's going on, there's nothing you can do, okay? I literally can't tell you. I'm not gonna let it happen to you, Virgil. Especially not you.
What are you talking about?
You've got a family. Go take care of them.
Elliot. Hey, you are my family. Elliot! Shit!
What are you doing, Elliot?
What's wrong with you, Elliot?
I've been having some really
strange thoughts about the
bye-bye man since we talked.
Miss Watkins, you can't talk to anyone about it.
Well, maybe I can come over to your house later.
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry, too. Believe me, but I've just been having the most vivid thoughts. Elliot?
Redman. Larry Redman. The writer. It was his nightstand. Miss Watkins. Okay, maybe I'll see you later. Maybe I'll have a fix for this. I gotta go. Thanks.
Oh, you're welcome.
I'll be there soon.
He almost got us, man. Oh, fuck. I almost killed you with a bat, but fuck, he's not gonna get us. He's not gonna get us.
I'm sorry, I can't call an ambulance because they're gonna say it.
You will, because I messed you up.
Baby.
Mrs. Redmond?
Leave.
Miss Redmond.
I said leave. Are you deaf or just defective?
Miss Redmond, did your husband write for the Register a long time ago?
You're too young to remember that.
Miss Redmond, you're still alive. I know your husband killed a lot of people, but I don't think he was crazy.
I need your help. Whatever you remember, there's a train, gold coins.
A hound?
He came to Larry. With the hound. What Larry told me gave me nightmares. I made him stop.
I understand. But I need you
to tell me everything Larry said. Please.
Larry was on a story of a teenager who killed his family. Poked around like a good nosy reporter and heard rumors, whispers about an evil, some kind of reaper that drove the teenager mad. Larry had to go nosing around and writing it down, and then it came to Larry, too, this nightmare, this name we must not think or say. But just 3 days after Larry got back from Iowa, I came home from work, October 20th, 1969, the day my life went turn, turn, turn.
Doing my job. That's what I do. I track down the story. That's what I was doing. See, once you know his name, you can't escape him. You see, he gets in your head and he makes you do horrible things.
Okay, shh. What horrible things? Who makes you do this? What are you talking about? Let's get you to bed, okay, sweetheart? Okay.
Listen. I didn't know if he was alive or dead. And then the hound, that's how you know he's coming.
When you see the hound and you hear the coins, that's when you know he's close by.
You understand?
No, Larry, I don't know what's happened, but I'm trying.
He listens for his name. Anyone could say it. It could be you, or it could be me. And it's just dumb luck, like the flip of a coin. And I heard the name, and I told Janie the name.
Don't think it, don't say it. What does this mean? What did you write? I don't understand.
He makes you see things, and he makes you do things. Who knows how many good people he's made do horrible things like this?
No! Oh, God, no, please. Please don't. Please put it down.
You think it's me? You think I did this? This is what happens. They say people snap. They say people go crazy. No, it's him. It's him that's doing it.
Shh, just put it down. Okay?
No. I love you.
But in the end, Larry was a hero. You tell people that. Larry erased him, you see. He did away with everyone who'd heard it before they could pass it on.
But not you. You're here. How did you survive all this time?
Survive?
Yes. How did you beat it?
I didn't beat it. I never knew it.
What?
If my husband told me the name, he'd have had to kill me with the rest. My husband controlled himself.
Your fucking husband wrote the name in the nightstand you sold, and I read it. He typed it in a dead article, and I read that too.
Don't you say it.
Your husband spared you, and he got me. He's in me now. He's in my friends.
You want my help?
Yes.
Here. Kill all the ones you told first, and then kill yourself. It's the only way.
No, there has to be another way.
Don't say it, don't think it.
It's a clue.
Look. Oh my God, he's coming.
What are you talking about? You didn't bring him here.
Don't you see it?
See what?
The light, hear the name. He's in your head. He makes us see things, hear things, tricks to make us afraid. He makes us afraid. And he grows. The more scared we are, the more real he gets. We make him real with our fear. We make him more powerful. Yeah, we give him the power, and he gets closer, and he hears us when we think of him. But maybe if we're not afraid, we take his power. Maybe if we're not afraid, he's nothing.
How could you figure it out in my Larry Not?
No, it's not real. No, it's not real.
I have you now, don't I? Come on, try another trick. Come on, try it. Where are you? Where are you? Oh my God. Sasha!
Pick up. Sasha.
Hey, Sasha.
You better not fucking hurt her.
Hey.
Sasha, I'm coming. I know it's hard, but don't be afraid. And don't believe anything you see. Play tricks. Okay, I'm ready.
Here.
Oh, God.
look like hell.
Jesus. There you are.
Elliot, thank God. You're back.
I'm not.
Hey, what's the matter? Elliot, what are you doing?
Get away.
Hey, come on. It's all gonna be okay. We're gonna be okay. I feel better.
Get away.
Elliot, it's me.
What the hell?
Elliot, I don't understand. What are you doing?
Help!
Elliot, come on.
I'm here, John.
Please, Elliot.
Help!
I don't understand, please.
No.
Come on.
No!
Please. Elliot, please stop. Will you just stop?
Get away from me! Get away from me! Get away!
Guys, it's freezing out here.
Hey, man, anybody home?
I got Alice here. She's here to cheer you up, buddy. Elliot!
No!
Jesus.
in there?
I hear something. Hello?
Open the door, you guys. We're turning into popsicles out here.
Go away!
Elliot?
Go away!
No, we're not going anywhere, Elliot.
Uncle, open up!
Please, get her out of here. Both of you, you need to go.
Elliot, open the goddamn door. I'm calling the police.
Good, do it!
Honey, why don't you go wait in the truck?
No, Daddy, I gotta pee.
Go to the truck, please.
Open the door, man. Come on.
Go. Go.
Elliot!
Move! Abby, what the hell is going on?
Virgil, please, get her out of here!
What the hell?
Okay, baby, I need you to listen to me, okay? I need you to go to the truck.
No, Daddy, I gotta go.
Go someplace close where I can see you and be quick, okay?
Outside?
Nobody's gonna see you, baby. It's okay. Go, 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 go. Elliot. Elliot, what is going on in there?
Don't think.
Elliot, what are you saying? What?
I have to do this. I'm not crazy.
Let me help you.
Oh, you can't. But I can help you. If you go. But I'm not gonna let you catch it. But don't say it. Don't think it.
Wait,
just
don't,
go.
Don't say what?
Fuck! Elliot!
Christ, what was that? Ellie, what was that?
So much.
Oh no! Look! Uncle Elliot!
It's okay. It's okay. The fire can't hurt him anymore.
So, this boy ran a librarian over, mutilated and murdered her children, and then killed his roommates and himself, and you had him in custody today, but you let him go?
Yes, but this is not some creepy kid pulling a Columbine, okay? I talked to him. Something is going on here. I can feel it.
I know, baby. Me too.
gave me the coins.
What are you talking about?
He must have left them out there for me to find.
Left them out where, honey?
In the little table. Outside next to the trash cans.
Was there anything else on this table?
No. Just some writing.
Writing? What did this writing say?
Daddy, you know I can't read in the dark. What do you think I am, a flashlight?
Song comes on like this. You think it's gone, but then it sticks. It always sticks. Keep your distance.
Yeah.
chainsaw comes on like this.